Hi everyone, my name is Alex and welcome back to my channel. As you know, just a few months ago, I moved to a city named Chongqing. It has over 30 million people here, pretty much the population of the country that I was born in. I did arrive on a flight from Thailand, and I remember that flight leaving a country that had over 20,000 active cases per day in Thailand. Things seemed pretty normal here for the first couple of months until now. And that's where I'm bringing you along today as we go into a quarantine zone in a city of 30 some million people. This video is not a video that I thought I would ever have to make. And let's see how China combats COVID. Let's go. Good morning, everyone. I've been on a long journey this morning, about 30 to 40 kilometers, and I've come out here for a special reason. This is not going to be an ordinary vlog that we have done before. I'm here with a group of community leaders in this area, as well as the people that I collaborate with at iChongqing. Well, I'm gonna get right to the point. Chongqing has had some cases of COVID here over the last week. Massive testing into the millions of people. It's time that we have an inside look on what happens in a major city the size of Chongqing, we'll say over 30 million plus, what they do, how they combat it, how they isolate it, how they test for it, and how they quarantine. Because a city of this size is like almost the size of the country. And if you don't get it under control here, you could have serious problems throughout China. So we're gonna get a really interesting inside look here. This is stuff that you don't see on the mainstream media. I'm gonna cue to the drone and we're gonna fly up above here and have an idea of the size of the area that we're gonna be looking at here that is quarantined. Imagine having to be in this isolation, even if you don't have COVID. It's a responsibility of the citizens of the city to keep community and the people of China safe. Okay, so let's go meet the people. So good morning, everybody. I'm here with Wang Yue. I think exactly, I pronounced that right. And she works in the publicity department in Chongqing here in this main area that I'm in. And this is quite a populated area that we're in right now. Well, let's go. Thank you. This is to the extent that we're getting here. If you see these lines here, this is a limit line. And that is all around this area here. And that is pretty much, it's quarantined. I'm not kidding you. It's not an apartment block. It's not a street. It's an entire area. It is a little bit overwhelming to see this. A city of this size can mobilize its infrastructure and combat this. And what I'm going to be doing is taking some extra precautions here because I'm getting a bit close to the situation, and as well as I'm going to be able to talk to one of the community leaders. Come join me.
How are they getting deliveries of food? Is he going to show us that?
It's 然后在我们的这个住户大厅，住户大厅通过我们的这个物业的工作人员送到我们公寓楼层下面的这个单元门口，由我们的工作人员，然后每天分两次，上午一次，下午一次，送到家门口，是这样，封闭楼栋是这样 ，OK
OK，
然后开展我们的人员排查，开展我们的大规模人群的核酸检查、核酸检测，是这样。现在我们这栋楼里面，封闭楼栋已经进行了三轮的核酸检查，现在都成功阴性，没有问题。
OK， he said like very fast, only in 1 hour.
那么我们下面是我们进行集中核酸检测的一个地点，因为每天我们的卫健委、我们的专家都要对现场进行评估，这样是没有问题的，因为我们每天都在现场，我们工作人员两天一次核酸检测，我们已经进行了四次都没有问题，放心。
He says this area is safe.
So there's even a special part how to put these gloves on. So now we're going to be moving on to the suit.And this is not necessarily the most comfortable thing to do, but I don't know if any of you guys have ever put one of these on before. But so this is the back, this is the front. This is pretty durable. The ones you actually buy in the stores are not as sturdy as these ones. Okay. Now, is this going to...Is this going to stay over top of my shoes? Is that how it works or what?
Wow, it's so hot. Holy cow.
Is this what exactly they're wearing?
If they are, I admire them even more.
Wow, that is hot.Yeah. Okay, hang on. Tried to do this at home. Okay, wow. Whew. Okay, other side. How on earth did they work in this? Jason?
Yeah?
I want you to experience this.
So guys, this is me in a hazmat suit.It's pretty hot, and I gotta tell you guys, the procedure was pretty intense. I have two sets of gloves on. I have a protective face shield. This is not the thin ones that you buy in the store. See here down, even on my feet, I've got another layer of protection. I also have protected headpiece as well. Mask underneath me is pretty secure. This area here is basically isolated, and now Jason's gonna be...that goes through this. Wow. You know, putting this on, Jason, you're going to have a whole new respect for these people that are working.
Oh, really?
Yeah, trust me.
I'm quite excited.
I never actually knew, first of all, how sealed you feel as an individual.
Yeah.
But how hot it must be to work.
Of course.
In this environment.
Can you imagine? Most of our Chinese medical staff, they wear this hazmat suit for almost 1 day.Yeah.
It's actually incredible.
Think about how can you eat, how can you drink, and how can you go to the bathroom stuff.
Yeah. This mask is the first mask I've ever actually felt that has really secured my breathing, and it feels like a suction cup that is just covering my nose and mouth. Even in the testing station, they have the identical outfit that we have on.
Yeah.
And even after 10 minutes, I'm feeling it.
Yeah.
It's almost exhausted.
So that's why we show the big respect to our medical people. Mm-hmm.
If we could ask just a couple of questions about how long these people are working, how long their shift is,
Every time they work for 2 hours, 2 hours they have the shift.
And we're in a relatively warm day today, but even in a hot day, that would just be, you could lose kilograms of weight being inside these outfits.
Very hot, very uncomfortable.
How many tests do you think we can do here during a day?
2,000 to 3,000 people.
Wow.
Yeah. 10 platforms.
10.
And now Jason is going to go through it. I'm going to, wow. I mean, even after 20 minutes, I'm exhausted. So I'm gonna actually kind of slowly try to peel down here if I can. And one by one, just show you every layer of peel back this outfit. You can open it up. I'm gonna take it off.
No way. The policy.
Can I take this off now?
No.
Gonna wait for you?
Yeah.
Okay. Apparently I can't take it off just yet. So.
So how does it feel in there, Jason? Have you got two sets of gloves on? You need one more set, yeah?
He will feel what I'm feeling.
I can't breathe, actually. It's feel not that bad. Yeah, I feel like well protected.
Right. You know? How do you think you would feel in this 12 hours?
I can't do it.
Maybe you couldn't
like
do it, huh?
25 minutes, I can't do it. Yeah, I saw people. I don't admire those people over there. Okay.
So Jason and I are just going to walk out here. Guys, I want to show you the level of... Can you help me with my hat here,
yeah,
Jason?
Yeah, yeah, sure.
Wow.
Okay,
right
there. Hold on.
Okay. Okay, but I've just got to push this up a bit now.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Okay, thank you. That's perfect.
I feel really, really hot.
Yeah, we're going to stay out of this area, but... Yeah. You can see that there's municipality police here that do monitor this area. There is no getting in here and just kind of wanting to visit a friend or anything in this area. This mall is closed, these businesses are closed, and these people in the apartment must sit and wait this out. Well, testing goes below here, but let's look outside China here for a second. You spent some time in America.
Yeah.
I mean, is this possible, this speed of organization, you think? Just in your honest opinion, is it possible to mobilize a medical, a police, a volunteer department, and have everybody cooperate within, the guy was saying within an hour or two that he had things under control?
I don't think so, they can't do it.
Even from Canada, we technically still don't have a contact tracing app. Now, if you are in contact with somebody that had COVID, your phone will get notified that you are within contact of somebody that had either COVID, and it runs on a red, amber, and green. Yeah, wow, I'm almost losing my breath in this.
It's okay. Yeah, he's gonna put something.
Whatever he wants to do. Yep.
Yeah.
So guys, we gotta actually put the camera in the bag here, right? Is that right?
Yes.
Say goodbye to the 1080p resolution because we forgot to actually put this camera in a protective bag here. So here we go. I know the microphone's not that loud, but we'll talk a bit louder. Okay.
Okay.
So we can go. Sorry about the quality, but
the volunteers over there, you see?
Yeah.
Yeah, they just get out
okay.
Delivered food.
Careful, Jason.
Yeah, I got you.
Oof. Even inside my visor is sweating. So.
四栋楼, the situation is there are four buildings.
Yes.
The first one, building one, building two, building four, like they are like the people are allowed to get out.
Yes.
Get down here, this area.
Whoa. Common area, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. But the building three,
yeah.
The people.
It's isolated.
Isolated.
Got it.
Now we are going to the building three.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yeah, let's go. So we're just double and triple checking to make sure that we're totally secure. So guys, this is the gate that is blocked off. And we're just gonna go under with the supervisor. And we've been brought up to one of the buildings that is contained. There are four buildings here that are under isolation. Building one, two, three, and four. One, two, and four are allowed to use some of the common areas to get out, get some fresh air. Building three is isolated. And in this situation, we've always got to remember that people have certain challenges. This person that we're going to visit now has diabetes, and the healthcare workers are aware of that. They need to deliver medicine, and we're gonna go talk to them. Wow, I've only been about 40 minutes into this hazmat, and it almost makes you dizzy, but let's go see the challenges that these people go through. It's quite difficult. It has to be challenging to be quarantined with probably no notice. That's very difficult, I think, for anyone to deal with. So it must be very worrying too from the family that actually can't get into the zone that maybe have elderly people. But the good thing is that the healthcare workers are aware of it and they are making sure that they're taking the health of these people very serious.
Okay, Jason, so help me out.
Yeah. How are things? Are you okay? Everything okay with you?
你现在怎么样？
就是
一切都好吗？
问
你一切都好吗？
啊，很好。我们社区都是重庆话，我说普通话。
Yes. And are you community?
还有那些工作人员啊，真的还不错啊，给我们家买东西啊，送礼送菜，反正自己需要的东西嘛哈。啊，还有个保安，那个队长，然后陪保安队员。
So you
know,
the community, the community has helped her a lot about everything.
She
got a lot to say.
Yeah,
she's quite excited.
How are you communicating with the rest of your family? Are they worried about you?
你就是家人们，就是会就不在自己的家人们会比较担心你的一个状况吗？
是那个的，家里面其他人担不担心你们那个状况？
担心，娃娃也很关心。我一个娃娃讲了的，我那个手机高头我还有一个我们同学讲了的，我们社区怎么样？你们可以看，还有时间性的，跟你讲嘛。我说感谢那个，感谢社区那个那些工作人员。我讲嘛，
You open up a door of somebody that probably hasn't had a lot of communication here in the last few days. So it's probably quite nice to her that we're visiting her as well. And we're really glad that you're safe.
Yes, everything's okay. Like her family is quite worried about her. But she said, no worries, like the community does everything for her. Like the food delivery, the medicine delivery, and everything.She's quite appreciative of everything the community does. 就是你还有什么其他的一些，就是你这社区想可能帮助你的一些这种情况吗？
还有啥子需要？
有啊，那个社区那个书记那天亲自送药。
不是，他是那个那种的，还需要我们社区提供啥子帮助？
其他的一些。
没得什么工作，我是就是觉得好久那个接触那个户外，我的心脏不好噻，因为我有那个冠心病的心脏。
这么着急？
哎，我好多月去住院。
我想还有今天。
Can we say 加油？
加油！加油！
加油！加油！加油！
加油！
保重身体！我跟你说，你有什么需求，给我们打电话。
不，我还要说，我们那个社区里头啊，不，给我专门还给我联系我们两个老人在屋头嘛哈。没得那个，但是我在网上又不会买东西那些，而且我那个高头没得一分钱的，好，而且还派了工作人员专门专职的给我那个给我送菜。我真的很感激政府，感谢我们社区各位领导和保安队长，还有及其保安，他们也很辛苦了。谢谢你们了，最辛苦的人是你们。
同志，
好，加油，加油。
Thank you。
好，我们打电话。
好，谢谢。
好，
谢谢。
Well, that has to be one of the most positive, energetic people I've ever met in quarantine. I got to tell you, that's all.That makes me feel a little bit better, Jason, to see that doing her duty as a citizen here and trying to make sure that the community is safe. Yeah. Is there anything else that she said that you want to make a note of?
Yeah, she said she does not know how to use the smartphone to order food.
Okay.
So the community is everything for her. I deliver.
All right. So sometimes when we have technological challenges, the community understands that?
Yes.
They communicate with her. But she's overall pretty happy.
She's quite excited, I say.
Well, thank you to everybody that's organizing this. What a challenge, huh?
Yeah.
We were told by one of the community leaders that there's 187 people in this building. Okay, guys, well, I didn't expect to get that much access. I'm here with Jason from iChongqing. It's been a real eye-opener for both of us. We've probably lost a couple of kilograms just in the last hour here being in these suits. And I want to thank all this personnel for being very cooperative to us. Basically, they've said, how can we help? What kind of message do we want to communicate? We've got our answers today. Oh, I'm exhausted. Okay, let's go. Thank you. Exiting this area now, the contaminated area, and we got to follow another procedure. It's very strict, but strict for a reason. One of the professionals did stop an individual either asking or trying to get too close to this area, and it was not a very pleasant conversation or communication. I'm going to my final stage here of taking all this clothing off, and then I will be done for the day. The building there, we walked in the building and there's four towers here. 1, 2, and 4 have been cleared. The case of COVID is in the third tower. What? I'm absolutely exhausted, not only from wearing the hazmat suit and the safety mask and the safety goggles and the hairpiece and the, you know, the protecting of all the clothes, but just coming out of that building was another 15 minutes of cleaning. I totally respect these conditions that these workers dealing with on a daily basis. Now they've invited me to take a COVID-19 NAT test, it's called. I have my green QR code on my phone. We'll see if my code gets accepted. So guys, this is the NAT test that all the people that have been informed to come here have to take. We sit down with a health professional. They take the information on our mobile phones. All right, guys, thanks a lot. Okay, here we are. Hi, oh boy, one of these. Okay, is this one gonna be in the nose? Huh? The nose, okay. Just awesome. If possible, the throat today. Wow. That's a little unpleasant, but I understand what it's there for. Thank you very much, Shashi, thank you. That's been quite the day here. If governments around the world can use this as a model, maybe we can make this pandemic come to a faster end. Guys, thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks from iChongqing for supporting this trip today. And thanks to everyone on my channel and Cyrus Jansen's channel. So I just want to thank everybody and the city and all the community and volunteers for bringing me down here today. I did request earlier, I was curious about the measures that the city and the communities were taking. And we got to remember, this is a big city, Chongqing, 30 some million plus in all its districts. Now, I got to tell you, I underestimated what was happening here today. Once again, China does surprise me in the measures that they are taking to have a zero COVID policy here. Today, I also experienced what it's like to go through the difficult part as a health professional, putting the hazmat suits on, the safety precautions that go through it. Every single part of it is extremely important. Now leaving what we can call a contaminated area and going back into the city, now that I know that this behind me here has been dealt with in probably one of the most efficient ways possible, it does give me confidence. In the next few weeks, we can look back at this and just say, you know, once again, we have fought the pandemic. I really appreciate that.